Matrix 2020 revision with crazy physics. Our singular aim is to make you matrix exam. Time to revise with crazy physics again, episode 4 of our maths, paper 1. Alright, we are just going to run through to, from episode 1 we've been looking at all of this algebra. Now we are sitting on number patterns. Alright, and the last question we did a number pattern had to do with just understanding what your quadratic is. And, you know, emphasizing the important points. And we did the last one, we said n equals to either 25 or 11. All right, let's look at the next question. All right, 10 adds a constant k to each of the terms in the pattern, given a new pattern Pn. Determine the general pattern. Okay, wait. 10 adds a constant k, so our pattern then changes. Our pattern then becomes 86 plus k, because 10 adds a constant k to each of the terms. All right, 119 plus k, 150 plus k, and then 179 plus k. What will our difference be? Our difference will not change, because it will be 119 plus k minus 86 plus k. And in case you want to write that down, this is what you do. Minus, if you don't put a bracket, then you're going to have a challenge. But since we add in k to every term, the difference remains the same. Alright, so 119 minus 86, we're still going to have our 33. And there we are going to have our 31. And there we're going to have our 29. And our difference will still be negative 2 and negative 2. And what does that tell us? Our a will still be the same. 2a equals to negative 2, which means a is negative 1. 3a plus b would still be 33. All right. And 3 negative 1 plus b. And that still gives us b as 36, which was what we did in episode number 3. And what changes now is this: a plus b plus c would be 86 plus k. All right, so negative 1 plus 36 plus c would be 86 plus k. And c, therefore, will be 51 plus k. All right, now what is our Pn? We do not know what k is. Our Pn, remember, it's a n squared plus bn plus c. So our a is still negative, so negative n squared. B is 36, and look at what c would be: 51 plus k. And that would be your answer there. All right, so the only thing that changes is just the last one. All right, let's look at the next question. The first three terms, I'm just going to Alright, just do some things here to make it easy for us to work with. Alright, let's take all of that out and create a working space for ourselves. Alright, the first three terms of an arithmetic sequence. Now, this is arithmetic. Please understand that when you talk about an arithmetic sequence, you are now dealing with a common difference. There is something I would tell you just now. I like to write this. All right. Grad. All right. Geometric ratio, arithmetic difference. Or you can say the difference. I like this other word. The difference between arithmetic, if you remember the statement, and geometric is ratio. And if you look at what I mean, the difference between arithmetic, it means when I talk about arithmetic, I'm talking about difference. And geometric is ratio. So geometric talks about ratio, which is written by grad. Geometric ratio, arithmetic would be difference. Okay? Because once you mix that up, we're going to have a big, big problem. Okay. Now, the first three terms of an arithmetic sequence are that. So, determine T30 in the term of Y. All right. So, my first term, T1, equals to 2Y minus 1. And my T2 equals to 4Y minus 1. All right. Automatically, it's arithmetic, so I need my D, which is T2 minus T1. 4Y. Now, the problem here would be your algebra. Once you miss your algebra, we're going to have a brick problem. Okay, so we have 4y minus 1. We distribute that. Now, what is 4y minus 2y? 2y. All right, because negative 1 plus 1 would give us 0. So, that's D. We do want T30. And that we know is A plus 29D. What is my A, by the way? 2y. Minus 1 plus 29, and what is D? 2y. Remember the formula that we used here. Let me just write the formula down for you. Tn equals to A plus n minus 1 D. All right. Now, what do we have? 2y minus 1. 29 times 2 would give us 58. And this will give us 60y minus 1. That's our T30. Very straightforward stuff there. Determine the value of y given that the sum of the first 30 terms, the sum of the first 30 of the sequence. Now we're talking about sum, 2.2.2. You must also remember the formula for sum, Sn equals to n over 2. And this, we must be able to prove. I will show you the proof in just a minute when I'm done with this. Now, determine the value of y given that the sum of the first 30. So I do have my S30, and that is negative 2820. Is 30, so I have 30 over 2. What is my first term, by the way? 2y minus 1. All right, 2y minus 1, and then what do I have? Plus, what is my n? 30, so which will give me 29, and my d is 2y. The rest here is simple algebra. Now let's work out our algebra. Okay, we need to work out that algebra part. Let's see if we can just... Okay, let's take this back. All right, let's create. Okay, we do have a new page created. And we can just clean what we don't need so that we work with what we need. Okay, all right. Can then drag this to a new space and then work things out here. All right, there's a bracket here. Good. So we have negative 2820. This will be 15. And if we expand this bracket, 2 times 2 would give us 4y minus 2. And this would give us 58y. Okay. I'm sure this is baby math now. 4y plus 58 would give us 62 minus 2. Now, it depends on you what you want. You might want to divide both sides by 15. And that will be what? 62y minus 2. And if I work it out, I need to move that over there. I have negative that over 15 plus 2 will be equal to 62y. Therefore, what is my y. I'm just going to use my calculator once here. All right, so we do have that negative 2820 divided by 15 and then plus 2. That would give us that. Whatever we get, we need to divide by 62, and that is negative 3. So y is equal to negative 3, and that is done. So that is just basic mathematics and algebra. They're understanding what your arithmetic is. Okay, I promised to show you a quick way to remember the proof of arithmetic, sum of arithmetic. All right, this is the principle that I will show you. If you look at 10, 10 can be written as 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. The same 10 can be written as 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. If you notice what I've done, I have just simply turned the numbers around from ascending to descending. All right, if I then add downwards, what is 10 plus 10? 20. 1 plus 4 would give me 5, 2 plus 3, 5, 3 plus 2, 5, 4 plus 1, 5. Now you would notice that these are same terms, same value. In how many places? In 4 places, which means I can actually say 5 times 4, and that's correct. Now this is what you need to understand when you prove your arithmetic. Somebody says it doesn't make sense. I'll show you. Now, I have Sn would be T1 plus T2 plus T3 up until Tn. All right. Now, what is my S first term, by the way? It is A. Plus, what's my second term? A plus D. All right. I'm just going to skip the rest until the last term, which is A plus n minus 1d. Now, that's the first step. I'm here. Now, look at what I did in the second step. Sn is to now descend the whole terms. What do you have? A plus n minus 1d plus, all right, a plus d plus a. Now, what did we do here? We added downwards. So, if we then add downwards, what are we going to get? Sn plus Sn will be 2Sn. Now, take the first and the first here. What do you have? A plus A would give us what? 2A plus N minus 1D plus so many terms in between. Let's just add the last one. A plus A, 2A. Now, do you notice what we got when we used numbers? We got 5s, same term. Oh, 2a plus n minus 1d. Awesome. Now, here I had 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, I could multiply that by 4. But how many terms do I have here? I've got n terms. So, I could pick one of that and multiply by the number. So, I pick one of this, 2a plus n minus 1d, and multiply by the number of terms, which is n. Now, can we divide both sides by 2? Sn, therefore, will be n over 2. 2a plus n minus 1d, and that's your proof. So, it's not something you should cram. Rather, understand the principle behind the whole system. Awesome. That's the proof of arithmetic. I will show you the proof of geometric as we then move on. All right, what is our next question to tackle? All right, Anne plans to start studying for her grade 12 final examination. On the first day, she studies 1 hour and plans to increase the study time with 15 minutes each day. As soon as Anne reaches 6 hours study time, she will continue to study 6 hours each day thereafter. Now, let's understand the whole dynamics. She starts studying for 60 minutes, all right, 60. And then the next day she plans to increase with 15 minutes. So our next day will be 75 minutes. All right. And if we continue that system of 15 minutes, the next will be 90, which forms a constant difference there of 15 minutes. So since we have a constant difference, what are we talking about? We're talking about an arithmetic pattern. All right. That's very key, identification. All right. Now she's going to continue this until she reaches 6 hours. Okay. Let me do this. She's going to continue this. It's arithmetic, right? We said it's arithmetic. I can just delete that. Until she reaches 6 hours. All right. 6 hours times 60 would be 360 minutes. So the last term is 360. Calculate the number of hours Anne will study on the 10th day. Let's create a sequence. Tn would be A plus N minus 1D. What is my A? The first term. All right. N minus 1. And what's my difference? 15. So what do we have here? 60 plus 15 N minus 15. 60 minus 15 would be 45 plus 15 N. All right, so on the 10th day, what would she have? T10 would be 45 plus 100. Okay, 15. I'm already multiplying in my head. 45 plus 150. All right, what would this be? 45 plus 150. All right, so this would give us 195, but this is minutes. The question says hours. What do? We convert that into hours by dividing by what? 60. All right, so 195 divided by 60 would give us 3.25 hours. Very key. Now, determine on which day Anne will study 6 hours for the first time. All right, so 2.1.2. What is our Tn going to be? That's what we're looking for N, rather, on which day when our Tn would be what? 6 hours. And our 6 hours is 360. All right, so if I use my general formula, Tn equals to 45 plus 15N. I'm working in minutes, all right, but I have 6 hours. So my last term is what? 360. 45. This is basic mathematics now. 360, all right, minus 45 equals to 15N. What is N? Just going to run through a calculator to make it fast. 360 minus 45. That's 315. And then divide that by what? 15. 21 days. All right. So N is 21. So on which day? On the 21st day. I hope that makes sense. On the 21st day. Now, calculate the total number of hours that N will study in the first 30 days. In the first 30 days. All right. A bit of thinking. First 30 days. Mind you, we're looking for total. Total refers to the sum. All right, so now, but to finish this, where we came from the slide, the first 21 days will be a day where the time increases up to 6 hours, after which she keeps that 6 hours study time for how many days? For 9 days. Remember, we're told that as soon as she reaches 6 hours study time, she will continue to study 6 hours each day thereafter. Which means from day 1 to day 21, it keeps increasing. Now, but from day 22 till day 30, it's going to be 6 hours daily. Now, the question is, how many days do we have here? Top minus bottom plus 1. 30 minus 22 give me 8 plus 1. So that's 9 days. So 9 days of 6 hours. And that will give me 54 hours. How did I get my 54? 9 multiplied by 6. Which means I can therefore look for the sum of the first 21 days, S21. Okay, and I'm sure you still remember the formula which we proved a while ago. Sn equals to n over 2, 2a plus n minus 1d. So my S21 will be 21 over 2. My first day was our first day, 60 minutes, remember? Plus, was it 60 minutes? Let's go back and just check. Yes, 60 minutes. Plus 21 minus 1, and our difference is 15. Don't forget, everything we're doing here is in minutes, okay? Because that unit could cause a lot of problem. All right, what do we have? We have 21 over 2. Let's divide that over 2. And then we have a bracket, the sum, that would be 120. All right, plus 20 times 15. Okay, 4410. All right, 4410, which I need to convert to hours, by the way, by dividing by what? 60. 73.5. All right. This is hours, because the question wants hours. Now, this is for the first 21 days. So, total for the first 30 days will be 73.5 plus our 54 of the remaining 9 days. Remember, it has all to be in hours. All right, and that will give us 5, 3 plus 4 would give us 7, and 5, that will give us 127 hours, or 127.5 hours. So be careful about the switch between hours and days. All right, but if you wanted to use hours in the whole question, it's fine. You could convert the 60 to 1 hour and then work through. So you have 127.5. Yes, and that is how we work through our questions. Okay, so we are then done with that. We need to move over to the next questions. Okay, and this will consider the series. But this we will then take on in, we'll start a fresh question and a fresh whole series when we get to episode number 5. I hope this approach and the little lessons you're putting together are quite helpful to help you prepare for your final exam. All right. This is Revision with Crazy Physics again. See you in lesson number 5. Goodbye.
Do you find mental science difficult or challenging, or you want to upgrade your matric? Crazy Physics is your answer. The home of quality and inspired teaching of maths and science. We offer the best service in teaching and simplifying concepts with fun and easy-to-remember dynamics. No one does it better. Many have had their dreams set in motion under our tutelage. We want to be part of your success story. We offer both actual and virtual tuition and homeschooling from grade 10 to 12. Are you working but need to upgrade your matric? Trust me, we got you covered, holding your hands till you make it for your matric upgrade wherever you are in South Africa. Our cloud and remote resources are adequately prepared to take you through every concept in detail. Simplified explanations, simulations to make you enjoy science and have fun with it. Textbook, workbooks, plug and play on the go class would also assist you as part of our resources. Why don't you just subscribe to our YouTube channel? Don't forget to hit the like button. Crazy Physics or Crazy Edu TV. Register now for 2021. Send us an email at info@crazyphysics.org.za. You'd never go wrong with us.